Good morning, people.
I mean, we're out 500 or 600 kilometers offshore. The ocean out there is a lot different than you're going to see from Cabot Tower or from anywhere close to the shore. That is one big angry sea. And it don't give a shit about you.
I've traveled the country over, stopped in each and every town.
We ran into a storm which cracked the windshield in the plane. So the plane had to put down an emergency landing in Montreal, where we had the plane repaired, and then flew on up to Baffin Bay, where we landed and stayed overnight in the International Hotel, which is a building with tar paper on the outside. And when we left in the morning, we had to get on an old boot plane, which flew us up to the Dew Line, which was a landing pad on the side of a mountain. As you were coming in, you could see wreckage and everything else all over the vicinity. Anyway, the pilot of that bush plane, he managed to land it, much to everybody's surprise. And we got off that, and then we had to transfer to a helicopter. When the helicopter took off from this little ledge, what I call it.
I lost it.
It went up, it started moving out over the edge of the ledge. Suddenly started to lose altitude very greatly. I don't know how far it would have dropped, but it dropped very sharply and very quickly. If you're up on a if you're in a helicopter, it comes up and then suddenly starts to head towards the ground. You get scared because you know you're going to die as soon as you land. But anyway, this pilot managed to get us up. Got us onto the rig safely. But on the way back, we had a small incident. The helicopter landed on the rig, took us on board. We came back, we got to this same little ridge. He was able to put us down there. We got onto this same bush plane. And the only way to launch the bush plane was to tie it down so that the pilot could rev up these engines and then let the ropes go and fling it off the edge of this ledge like a slingshot. He managed that, and we actually managed to get back into Frobisher Bay Airport, and we got home that night. The next morning I heard on the radio or TV or something that the previous evening the bush plane actually crashed into the mountain on the side of the Frobisher Bay Airport with 21 crew members on board. All were lost. So there was 21 guys that I knew that I worked with every day died in that incident. Oh, yeah, that can frighten pants off you. And, I mean, it's your life on the line. And I haven't done anything dangerous since that time. Not even skateboard. I do nothing.
Good morning, people. I just landed in your town.